How many types of locks are available in UiPath?
I'm sorry.
Fine. So let's say that the bot fails in your project for one of the transactions. How will you make sure that it will continue for the next transactions without completely breaking the process?
Okay, if the bot, if one transaction is failed.
Correct.
If one transaction is, can you repeat the question once again?
Let's say that you have 100 rows. In that 100 rows, you automated the process. Now, in that 100 rows, there are 10 rows that are randomly failing. You don't know when they will fail.
Actually, we if the bot is failed, we can get to know whether it's a business exception or application exception. So it depends on the exception which we get. If it is the business one, we have to go there and check the rules which we have defined in that. Yeah, if it is an application one, mostly we don't get any application failures. It probably can be a business one. So the business one, we can't do it when the bot is running, or that we have to like stop the bot, or we have to wait till the bot stops and then we have to go through that particular exception. Like for example, if you feed an Excel sheet into a bot and somewhere the validation has been went wrong in one of the row in or 10 rows in the Excel sheet, so you can't do when the bot is running there, right? Yeah, we have to again check the proper validations and we have to get through that.
Okay, so what is the difference between a business rule exception and a system exception?
Yeah, the business rule exception, the name itself is telling the rule. So basically, the developer or the requirement gathering when we does, we have some rule, set of rules that we have to do when the bot, we are creating the bot. So that rules should be defined properly. If some or the other transaction is, you know, not being set to that rule, so we will get some business rule exception. Maybe selector not found, or the input data is not properly validated, file not found, file is not opening. So this all comes under this business rule exception. Whereas system exception, it is mainly basically about the application. Maybe the application is not responding, or it has been suddenly shut down. I mean, came down because of some huge processes running, something like that.
Okay, and there is a system exception in the middle of the process. How will you make sure that the bot kicks up again? Instead of stopping the bot and starting it again, what are the different ways where we can make sure that the bot continues?
Whereas in RE framework, it automatically again starts to, you know, if we get any failure, it again go and start the applications once again. But whereas in normal, we can just generally use try catch method, and then in that try catch, if we get any exception like system and all, the application is not found or something like that on the screen, we can put exception. I mean, we can put in the catch field to start the application again and to work on it. Where does it stop?
Okay, so how good are you with RE framework?
Yeah, I can't tell that I'm so good in that, but yeah, I can understand, I can do the projects in that.
Okay, so we are half an hour up for the interview. So in the next half an hour, let's do a short project. Is it okay?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, please share your screen as well as keep UiPath on the screen.